a past paper question from IB Math Studies. It was taken from November 2013. And it's paper two, so it's quite a long question. It's question two from that paper using time zone zero. So I'm going to go through the solution. It seems quite complicated, but it's actually quite straightforward. You'll just have to make use of different formulas from your data buckets. So you have a manufacturer has a contract of to make 2,600 solid blocks of wood. Each one has to be in the shape of a triangular prism. And you have these lengths. Now make sure that all the lengths are mentioned in the diagram, so do match them up. For part A, you need to calculate the length of AC, so you need this length. And I always tell my students to extract the length they need or extract the shape on the from the diagram. So you have this case and you need AC. Now I'm gonna use the cosine rule here. I'm not gonna use Pythagoras because I don't have a right angle triangle. You have no way of knowing if this is a right angle triangle unless they tell you, or unless you do quite complicated calculation, which doesn't make sense for a three mark question. But we do go the straight root method of using the cosine rule. The tips and tricks for using a cosine rule are explained in another video, so I'm not gonna dwell on this for too long. So you could please watch the video if you're unsure about how I'm substituting in the equation. So the substitution situation is quite important. So I'm gonna use the cosine rule where you have two forms. I'm gonna use the length format. So in this case, I have AC squared, so that's my missing length. And then I have B squared plus C squared, and this could be any of the 24 or 30. So it doesn't matter which order. And then the equation goes with minus 2BC, so minus 2 times these two, minus 2BC. And then it takes cos A. And cos A is usually just the angle that matches with your missing length. So if this was your missing length, then the angle, even if you had this angle, for example, you don't really need it. You're gonna use the 35 because that matches with your missing length. So cos 35. Do make sure that your calculator is on degrees, and once you've gone through it, you're gonna end up with AC squared is equal to 296.41. Please remember that you need to square root your answer. It doesn't make sense to have length of 24 and 30 and then end up with 296. So AC is equal to the square root of that. And that is 17.2, and that is to three significant figures. Generally, if they don't tell you how many significant figures, it's three. So you'll get one mark for substituting the cosine formula and one mark for correct substitution, and then finally getting the answer correct. So we got 17.2 for that one. So the next question is to calculate the area of this triangle. Again, take it out on the side. You have 24, you have 30, you have 35, and this time we have 17.2. Now, you're not allowed to use the half times base times height, because if you pick any of these as your bases, let's say 30 as my base, I'll need the perpendicular height, which is this. I need this height and I don't have it, and it's going to be quite long for you to attempt to find it. So we go the easy route of using the other formula, which is half AB sine C. A and B and C have a special relationship where, again, it's the sandwiching situation. So you have, these are your A and C will be in between them. So for example, if you actually had this length, then your A and this angle, sorry, then your A and B will be these two lengths, the 24 and the 17.2, and then your C will be whatever is there. So you need to make sure you match them together. I will not make use of the 17.2, and try to avoid any numbers you found in the previous questions, because it just means that you are gonna complicate the solution. So you have a half times 24 times 30 times sine 35. You are not allowed to use cosine in this rule. And once you substitute in, you are going to get 206 centimeters squared. So 206.487, but this is to the three significant figures. There is a special case written in the marking scheme where it says if the candidate has assumed that ACB is 90 degrees and they substituted for half AB, half times base times height, you get a maximum of 2 marks in this case. So, but do try and avoid it, because what you found right now in the area of the triangle will be quite useful in the next parts. So we have 17.2, 206 for the area. So and area is 206, so just keep it on the side. Part C says, assuming that no wood is wasted. So this assumption is usually just to make your calculations easier. Show that the volume of the wood required to make 2,600 blocks, which is what the manufacturer has to make, is 13,400,000 centimeter cube, correct to three significant figures. To find the volume of a triangular prism, or any prism, you take the area of the face and you multiply it by the length or the height that it extends with, which is why I said it's important to get the correct area. So the volume will be what they call the area of cross-section multiplied by the length or the height. So this is just how much does it extend. This triangle will extend 25 centimeters until it gets to here. So the volume is just your 206. You could also pick the more decimal places. So this was the up to three decimal places, and then multiply by this 25, because that's how much this triangle is extending, or it's repeating 25 centimeters. And you are gonna get 5,162.175. Now you're gonna sit there and go, wait, this is not 30 million. And it doesn't make sense to have a volume of 13 million. Well, remember that this is the volume of one block. The volume of the 2,600 blocks will be just taking this amount and multiplying by 2,600. Now, you could have written all of this in one line. It is allowed according to the marking scheme, but we are going to just do it step by step. So you get 13,421,655, that centimeter cube. Again, it doesn't match with this. What's wrong? Well, they've rounded their answer to correct to three significant figures. So you're going to look at this 13,421,655. And you're going to look, well, this is my first significant figure, second significant figure, and this is my third significant figure. I'm going to look at the number next to it. It's 2, which means I do not add anything to the 4. So this remains the same, but then everything else turns into a 0. Remember, if you didn't add the 0, then you are actually rounding a 13 million number to a 3-digit number, which doesn't make sense. So you need to add these zeros as placeholders. So now you have three significant figures there. And there you go. It's rounded to three significant figures. You cannot get the final mark, so it's a 2-mark question. You won't be able to get the final mark unless both the unrounded and the rounded answers are seen. So you need both this and this step just to show that you've rounded. So you need to be careful with this point. Okay, so again, 17.2. Let's go to part D. So it says, write 13,400 in the form of A times 10 to the power of K, where A is greater than or equal to 1, less than, strictly less than 10, and K is an integer. Really complicated, fancy way of saying just write it in scientific notation. So you need to write it in standard form. Standard form means that the first number, the a, your first digit. It could be a decimal, it's fine if it's a decimal, but as long as it's less than 10. Now, how can I make this number appear less than 10? Well, if you have, if the decimal place is here, remember it's a whole number, then if I move it to this point, I can actually make it look less than one. So, sorry, less than 10. So if I do this, I don't need to write the rest of the zeros. If I move the decimal place here, it's gonna be a number. It's gonna be a number between 1 and 10. But then I need to multiply it by a number of place values to compensate for this movement. So I moved it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's gonna be 10 to the power of 7. You get one mark for writing 1.34 and one mark for having 10 to the power of the correct power. You get no marks if you wrote 13.4 times 10 to the power of 6, for example, because the first number, this A, has to be between 1 and 10 and strictly less than 10. So this is standard form. There's a video on standard form if you need more help in this area. So for part D, sorry, we did D. For part E, show that the total surface area of one block is 2,190 centimeters squared. Correct to three significant figure. Total surface area is you adding all the areas. And so adding all area. And students surprisingly do lose marks in this, even though you can get really easy marks by doing the simplest calculations. So don't leave this blank. Try as much as you can. And if you get to the final answer, great. If not, at least you've scored a few marks for yourself. Well, adding all the areas, how many areas do you have? If you look at this shape, you have a triangle here and a triangle there, and they're identical. So you have two triangles. Each is has an area of, and we found it already, each has an area of 206.487. Again, notice that we gave the rounded answer previously, but we're using the unrounded answer for the area. So we have two triangles, and then the other faces you have a rectangle here. So this has an area of 25 multiplied by 24. You also have a rectangle here, which has an area of 25 times 17.2. You also have a third rectangle here, which has an area of 30 multiplied by 25. So if you find the area of each of these, you actually get the mark. So don't lose marks on easy steps. So you have three rectangles in there. So you need to make sure they find the area of all of these faces. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 faces, and then you add them all together. So first we have 206.487 times 2, and then we have the area of this rectangle, which is 25 times 24. And then we have the area of the rectangle at the back. So we have this rectangle, which is 25 times 17.2. And again, you can use the unrounded form of this because we found it in part A. So you have 25 times 17.2168. So we're adding a couple more decimal places. And then the last one would be the rectangle at the bottom, which is 30, and then multiplied by 25. So this is a 25 length. So 30 multiplied by 25. So do them separately, then add them all together, and you should get an area, a surface area of 2,193.26. So there are more decimal places there. And then if you you need to round your answer to three significant figures, so it's going to be 2,190 centimeter square. Okay, so again, because the answer is did Ram do theirs to three significant figures. So you go 1, 2, 3. This is my third significant figure. You're going to go 3. Well, this is less than 1, so I don't add anything to the 9. So 2, 1, 9 stays as it is. And then obviously I need to replace this 3 with a 0 just to hold the place value. Anything after the decimal point, you don't add a 0 or else it will be considered as significant values. So we've done this part. We found the total surface area, and it's going to be useful for the second part. So the blocks, so we're still talking about this 2600 blocks, if you go back to the beginning of the question. So the blocks are to be painted. 1 liter of paint will cover 22 meters square. Okay, so calculate the number of liters required to paint all 2600 blocks. Well, to cover all of this, I need to know how much area am I covering. So if I know that the area of one is, let's take the rounded answer. So if the area, the surface area of one is 2,190. So the surface area of 2,600 of them will be just this multiplied by 2,600. So this will give me 5,694,000. Okay, so this is the surface area for all 2,600. Now, if I know that this is how much all of them are going to cover, I need to see how much 1 liter can fit into, how much of this 1 liter do I need to cover. Now notice that you have a different unit here. You have centimeter square here, but you have meter square. So I need to convert, this into meters squared. Now to go from, this is on the side in case you didn't know, to go from centimeter to meter, you divide by 100. But then to go from centimeter squared to meter squared, you need to divide by 100 twice. So that will be dividing by 10,000. Because you have a square, you're actually not just dividing one length, you're dividing two lengths. So you have to divide by 100 twice. So I'm just going to convert this to meters, and that is going to be 569.4 meters squared. Well, now it's much easier to deal with. If I have 1 liter, it covers 22 meters squared, then how many liters would cover 569.4 meters squared? Always use this equivalences. You can use it in any example that has a proportional balance, so even percentages and so. 1 liter has 22. I don't know how many liters will cover that many, but once you've formed this, you can always cross multiply. So we're going to cross multiply. And so you end up with 1 multiplied by 569.4. And that is equal to 22 times x. And so this simplifies to this, obviously. And so you divide by 22 on both sides to get rid of this 22. So you end up with 569.4 divided by 22. Is equal to x. And so how many liters do I need? Well, that will be 25.8818 liters. Again, rounding to three significant figures as the paper would expect you to. So this is 65.9 liters. The IB paper will accept 26, but don't risk it. Some might, some not. So you are seems quite long, but we can all simplify all of these steps into one simple one. So it was the area of one, surface area of one multiplied by 2600 blocks. And then we divide this by 22, which is what we did here. But then we're also dividing it by 10,000 to convert it to meter squared. So this is what it simplifies to. So 1 mark for multiplying by 2600 and divided by 22, and then 1 mark for dividing by 10,000. Hopefully the I know it's quite a long video, but hopefully all the concepts were explained. We're covering so many things, so many different concepts in math all at once. And this was a paper 2 style question, so you can try and see where you could guarantee your marks and where you could improve.